Let us resume the previous session. We were seeing how to use the measure toolbar, in which we wanted to find out how to measure the area. The different methods given over here are clearly understandable by selecting the two elements in this way, and let us have another ellipse. Okay. Now select the measure area option, and when you have the method selected as element, you can select this, and the area as well as the perimeter of this element, that is the rectangle, is displayed over here. Alright. Now let us choose the option called measure distance between points from here to here. This is around 100, and from here to here this is around 40. So this is 100, this will also be around 100, and this is 40, so this will also be around 40. So totally it has to be, that is the perimeter, that is the sum of the sides, has to be 200. Two horizontal lines, that is sum of two horizontal lines is 200, and the two vertical lines are 40 each, so totally around 280. 40 plus 40, 280. Similarly, when you go with this, you can see the last perimeter which we had measured was around 280 itself. Horizontal lines are 100 units long each, vertical lines are 40 units long each, approximately, that is. And when you sum it all up, that is sum of all the four sides, which gives the perimeter, it is 276. Similarly, length into breadth is given as 3800. Right? Alright. Next option is intersection. When you select the intersection option, it will allow you to select this element and this element. The intersecting region between the two elements is highlighted in this way, and then you can right click. When you do right click, the area and the perimeter of this region from here to here, that is the intersecting region, the common region between the ellipse and the rectangle, is displayed over here. Okay. Select this option, and right now display centroid is enabled. Let us deselect this. Right. Now you do not have anything over here. After the intersection option, next go for the union, select this element and select this element, the common region between both of them, sorry, the combined area between both of them together by joining both of them is given or is displayed over here in this way. Then you can go with right click, and the perimeter and the area of the combination is displayed over here. Similarly, go with difference, select this, and go with right click. The perimeter as well as the area of the difference is given, that is this ellipse minus the rectangle. Or select difference, select this rectangle, and select this ellipse. So rectangle minus the ellipse, this region is displayed over here. Right click in order to see that region's area and perimeter. When you go with flood, select two points, and this is how the area is displayed in between the closed loop which is formed in between those lines. That is your flood option. All these options we have already seen in the patterns toolbar. The last one is the points option. Select points, and wherever you click, in this way a closed loop will be forming. Right click in order to find out the area and the perimeter of that closed loop, which is formed by selecting the points. That is the measure area option. The next option over here is measure volume. Select this, and this, when you select, it will give you that the area, sorry, the volume of that particular element. Right now all these options, whichever you used, have been related to 2D, but measure volume is related to the three-dimensional modeling of a particular object. When you have a solid, only then you can find out its volume. right? That is the reason when you click it now, you will be getting in the status bar written as 3D only tool. This tool is related only to 3D. If at all you are performing any 3D operations or 3D solids have been created in your file, then you can measure the volume of that 3D object. So this is about your measure toolbar. Let me select all of it and delete it. Now whenever we were selecting this, I'll go with undo. Now you can see I am trying to select this line, this arc and this ellipse as well. And when I select the first line, those grip points help me know that the line has been selected. But once I press down the control key on my keyboard and select the arc as well, the grip points are not displayed. A very light shade is applied to the objects that have been selected. You can again press down the control key and select the ellipse as well. This is how these three elements have been selected. If you delete them, if you hit the delete button on the keyboard, the three will be deleted. But right now you can see that the selection, whenever you're making any selection, the objects are not highlighted properly or in a strong or a visible color. You can see I'm selecting this and selecting this, selecting this. When I see it from a far off distance, that is from a zoomed out state, then it's difficult to find out which are the elements that have been selected. In order to rectify this problem, you can go over here, select the utilities option and click on the key in. This key in option is used to alter or modify the interface which is present over here in MicroStation. Right now you would want to change this selection, right, selection color. So I'm going to key in a particular command over here, type in set. The set gets selected over here, after which you need to select, go with the space, highlight, type in HILITE, and when you select the set highlight, these two keywords, then next you can select a particular color from here. Let me choose any color over here. Let it be, say, cyan. Alright. After you have selected the entire loop over here, that is the entire key, you need to press this key in button. Or you can even go with the enter. So currently we have set the highlight color as cyan. I'm going to close this now. And when I select this, it is not only going to show me the grip points, but also the color has changed. The color has changed to cyan. Select this, press down the control key, select multiple objects. Now all those objects are visible clearly. Whenever you are making the selection, each and every object will be shown clearly. This is how you can change the selection color. Go to utilities, click on key in, going to set. You can even browse over here. There are various options over here which can be altered or modified depending upon the requirement. Under each option you have a different set of subgroups, and for each group again you have different types of tools over here, that is different settings over here. In this way you can select any of these options. Let me again go back to set, space, go with highlight. Next you can select the color as well. Let me choose magenta this time, go with key in. When you go with key in option, it means that you have enabled or you have entered that particular setting. You can close this now, and now when you select this, they will be highlighted in the magenta color. That is how you are going to modify that particular color. Alright, I'm going to stop this session over here.